Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be the long awaited nursery tour. This is little Miss Capri's nursery. She's 6 months already. I know I have been saying I'm gonna share it, I'm gonna do it, but finally I think the majority of the room is done. And at this point, any little details that I still have to change, I figured I'll just throw it into a vlog when I have updates. If I have updates, we may just leave it like this, we'll see. The only thing that I think I'm definitely 100% going to be changing is actually the blinds in this room. I currently have white wood ones. I may be inserting, like, maybe doing some other ones. I'll insert a little clip here for you guys to see what I'm looking for, what I'm possibly gonna change to. I would love your feedback if you could let me know down in the comments to keep what I currently have or go with the new ones. I'll insert a little clip here so you guys can see what the ones that I'm contemplating on ordering is gonna look like. I'll give you a full room tour, go from section to section, see how everything looks. I'm really happy how it turned out. I basically get these visions in my head and then it just kind of takes me a while to pair everything together. I'm gonna have Capri in her little Moses basket playing down over here by me. So if you hear little baby noises in the back, just know that it's her. And we're gonna see if we get through this tour. We're gonna see if she cooperates so I could get through this tour. Be sure to thumbs up if you guys enjoy videos. We are so close to 50,000 subscribers. So consider hitting that little subscribe button if you're not yet already. And let's get right into this nursery tour. So I just put Capri down and I'm starting off with this wall right here because this is basically the statement piece and the area of the room that I wanted to stand out the most. So right back here, what makes it so bold and kind of stand out from the rest that you'll see is more of a neutral palette is this wallpaper. If you're new to my channel, I waited on my gender of my baby not until delivery day. So once I gave birth, I found out if it was a boy or a girl. So a lot of the larger pieces, I stuck with neutral elements. That's why a lot of it is kind of gender neutral. And then once she came, I knew I would add touches, whether it was a boy or a girl, to incorporate their gender just a bit. So this wallpaper was one of those items. I knew I wanted to do a wallpaper wall in here, but I was just toying around with what it would be based on the gender. So this wallpaper here is actually from Wall Blush. The things that stand out are, of course, like the green leaves and the touches of terracotta that are in these blooms, which I think are absolutely beautiful. And I wanted to incorporate her name somehow. So I found these beautiful letters. This is probably one of the number one questions I get asked over on Instagram is, where are Capri's name letters from? They're actually Hobby Lobby, so I don't have a link for them. Then moving on down to the crib is this one here. I wanted something affordable. I wanted something that was modern looking. So this one here, I absolutely love. They have different tones. So you can go with all white. You could go with like white and walnut, white and gray. I went with the white and neutral color wood because that's the whole palette that I'm going for the remaining of the room, like I said. And I will be inserting clips here, like zoom in shots, so you guys can see things a little more in detail, a little more in depth. So just as I'm talking through, I'll insert some close-up shots of each of the details of this space. So that's that for the crib, 100%, highly recommend it. Like I said, definitely affordable, and it goes with a lot of different themes that you may be doing in your room for a boy or a girl. Then coming down to my mattress here, this is actually a Newton mattress. I love it because it is 100% breathable. Most of the time, Capri just rolls onto her belly and she loves sleeping on her stomach. So this gives me the peace of mind as a mom that it's breathable, it's machine washable, and hypoallergenic. So I absolutely love that mattress. If you guys are in the market for one, I suggest that. And then back over here that I was kind of blocking is actually her mobile. This mobile I purchased as well prior to giving birth to her because I thought it would be so precious and perfect for a little boy or a little girl. I didn't have a mobile for Mila and I always wish I did one. This one is custom made on Etsy. They could do tons of different themes and looks. I love that it had the cactus and the fringe, very boho looking but still sticking once again with neutral. Absolutely, absolutely love it. Now moving on to this little corner here. I knew I wanted to put something here because, as I mentioned, this whole area was meant to be a statement and it was just missing something. And this was the element that it was missing. This piece, I knew I had to have it in her nursery because it actually holds a really significant meaning to me. My grandma actually passed away last February and this was her chair. She had this in her home. My grandfather gave it to me and I was like, I know exactly what I have to do with it. It goes with her whole feel of her modern boho nursery. And just having a piece of my grandma in here, I just feel like I feel her presence in here, and keeping her safe, keeping it right beside my daughter's crib when she sleeps at night just gives me an extra peace of mind. And all I did to it to kind of bring it back to life was add some new cushions, because the ones that they had were of course years old. I think she had this chair for like over 30 years, my grandpa said. So I just changed out some new cushions, and then I added this beautiful floral garland, which actually ties in nicely with the wallpaper, once again, bringing in those soft shades of terracotta. Okay, so moving on down here to the floor, this is her rug. I wanted something that had more of a boho feel because I'm mixing boho with modern. This one was so pretty. I love all of the print on it. I love that it has fringe details on the end. And then I especially love, originally when I ordered it, it said it was a blush color, but to my surprise when it came, it's like this gorgeous soft terracotta, bringing in the colors of that garland and the decals on the wallpaper. So on this part of the room, this is our little like changing area and dresser. Down on the floor, for decor purposes, I use some pampas grass. The vase that I have down below, I'll just bring the camera down a little bit so you guys can see it. I absolutely love, because it's actually like a thick cardboard material, so the kids can knock it over like 500 times and no one will be harmed, nothing will break. This is my absolute favorite pampas grass. You guys have been selling it out like crazy, and it's by far my favorite. The highest quality, the prettiest stems, they're fluffy, and I just feel like they look perfect in any space that you're going to be adding it to. Then working your way back up here to the actual dresser. So this dresser, I had to keep in mind, I was playing around with whether I was going to get it or not, because I was worried, is it too girly, or if it's a boy, is it not boy enough, like what was going on with it? But I just loved it, and my mom actually bought this for us, so she was like, you've been eyeing it for so long, you really want it. And I feel like this is definitely a piece, it wasn't crazy expensive, but it also wasn't like super affordable, but it's definitely something that's going to grow with her years to come as her styles change, as she gets bigger. So I definitely suggest investing in pieces like this for your kids' rooms that they can grow with. So this has, once again, the light natural color wood at the top, as well as coming down like waterfall on the sides to tie in together with her crib. And then my favorite part of it is actually the front. I'm not sure you guys can see it, but it has this beautiful like design element engraved in the white area. And then of course, pops of gold for the little handles. So this is her dresser. I love that it's long. I have everything labeled and organized in the drawers, but for the sake of the length of this video, I'll go ahead and include that like in a separate in-depth baby organization, showing you exactly how I have all of her clothes and items organized in her closet, as well as this entire dresser. Then moving on top of the dresser, I have this changing pad here. This was the very first purchase that I actually made for baby. But a little tip for you guys, I'm not sure if this exact one is still available. If it is, I will have it down below. But check out the second link that I'm gonna have down there for the dresser. I'll call it like dupe changing basket, because they have it on Amazon now and it's literally a fraction of the cost. I wish I would have known that, because I would have bought that one. And then in here I just have a changing pad, because of course no one's gonna lay their baby on like a hard basket. And it's this beautiful mustard shade I decided to go with. So I lay that in there. This is machine washable, so I just kind of throw it in the wash, air dry it about like once a week. And then right beside it, I just have this little diaper changing station that I like to keep diapers as well as wipes to make it really easy for diaper changes. I decided to move the camera a little bit closer so you guys can see a bit better. But moving on to above the dresser, if it was a boy, I was gonna do more like a name, like wooden sign above here. But since she was a little girl, I wanted to add a feminine touch to this dresser area. And I thought this starburst mirror went absolutely perfect. If you guys watch a Home Goods haul that I did, that's where I got this one for $15. It was in the clearance section. I really lucked out with it. I love that she can see like the reflection of the items on the other side of the room. And it just gave a really pretty touch tying in the boho, while also giving it a little bit of feminine style to it as well. This area, we have her shelves. I 100% wanted to incorporate some shelves for the baby nursery. I thought it looked really cute, as I could add some things that I need to reach for, and then of course add a little bit of decor. So these shelves are actually from IKEA, and they're a little bit longer, but since it didn't really work, since this dresser that we have isn't the widest, I had my husband Mike just cut basically to the measurements that I needed, and then he drilled these on a little bit closer to how we needed to be the width of storage that we needed for our particular space. So you do have the raw wood where he cut, but he faces it this direction against the wall where no one's gonna even notice. So for the first one, we have her little name sign that we have her name, Capri Grace. Her weight, 7'11", her height was 20 and a half inches. She was born on my dad's birthday, April 17th, 2020, at 4:24 p.m. We have this wooden brush set that I absolutely love. I use this on the daily after her baths. So we have this right here, easy access for me to use after bath time. Then a little candle, a neutral giraffe for decor. This little guy was actually from Hobby Lobby. And then moving on to the top one, we have a pretty little floral. I bought this also at Hobby Lobby before having her. It says, I love you more. Both of my daughters never took pacifiers, so I used this as a little teether. And then I found this little guy on Amazon. I thought it was so cute because I'm a YouTuber to have that little element in her room as well, and it's really neutral. Working our way down now to the floor section beside the dresser. She kind of plays in this little play gem when we're upstairs in her room. We have a second one downstairs in our living room. But I have this little like faux fur rug here. It makes it really cozy and comfortable for when she's playing here. And she just loves these things. She kind of hangs on them, tries to chew them, you know, all those good things to keep her entertained while I'm doing things. And I love that not only is it something she could play with, but it also added like a little bit of decor, and the whole color and neutral palette of it went with the whole rest of the room. All right, I'm gonna bend down here for the rest of the video, it looks like, so you guys can see me better. But over here we have this little nightstand table. I like to put little end tables in my daughter's rooms right beside my rocking chair, because since I am a nursing mom, I felt that just always been easy for me to nurse them, have like a water bottle if I need it. We do story time over here, and I do have her little Hatch Baby sound machine here. So depending if we're gonna do music, if we're gonna do white noise, has been a godsend, especially when she was a newborn, that just, we lived off this Hatch Baby. Then this little guy is just for decor. I think I'm gonna put like a little electric tea light candle in here. And then I have this vase from Target, and this is actually fake pompous that I got at Target as well, but it works really great to have right on here. And I'm just obsessed with this table. I'm gonna bring the camera a little closer because I'm not sure if I have any B-roll to insert of this table, but how beautiful is this, you guys? It's so boho and pretty. I love the neutral colors. I found this little guy at Home Goods. I think they have similar ones on Wayfair though, so I'll definitely check for you guys. And I have a little lamp because when we're reading stories, I of course needed a little lamp to have in this space. Okay, so this little rocking area here, we're about to sit in it because Capri's getting a little fussy right now. But this is where, like I said, we do story time, we hang out, we do lots of nursing sessions in here. So I just have a little blanket, I have a little pillow. This was the same rocker I had for Mila. So once again, repurposed it. I was glad I did a neutral shade because it could go with any of my kids' nurseries in the future. Okay, and for the final area in her room, right beside her rocking chair, I have this really beautiful accordion hanger. I wanted to add, I was thinking what I can do on this wall because it was a large space to fill. But I didn't want to put like huge wall art and things that were going to be expensive. So this is a great affordable option to kind of fill up wall space in your nurseries. You can hang swaddles on here. I have bibs, I have clothing, of course some decor elements as well. But this little guy I found on Amazon, I want to say it was under $20. I put just a little dream catcher. These bibs we like to put on Capri if we're doing like little photos and things like that. Another Amazon find. It came like in a 3-pack. I honestly, now looking at this, I think every item is Amazon. This little rainbow little decor piece is also Amazon, and this adorable precious outfit as well. One last area that I forgot to mention, and I'm just whispering because Capri is napping already in her crib, but right above me is the chandelier, and I was dying for a tiered fringe chandelier. All the ones that I looked for were too large and weren't going to work for this space because these ceilings are actually less than 8 feet up here, but I found this one. I love the pops of gold, and it literally is ideal for this space. All right, you guys, so that is it for today's nursery tour. I think little Miss Capri has the perfect space to grow up in. I'm really happy how everything came out. For me, my favorite space has to be either the wallpaper wall or this little like reading nursing area that I'm in multiple times a day. Let me know down below what was your favorite portion, and I will talk to you guys all in my next one. Bye!